Welcome back to Let's Play Creeper World. When we last left off, we had finished this planet, and you notice this one is a different color. That's where the artifact has led us to planet Ara, and to the... Ooh, Gorvis. To the next few planets. The map worries me. Fascinating. The coordinates we got from the artifact on Cetus have taken us to the Step Pyramid ruins on a world called Ara. This world was one of the first worlds destroyed by the Creeper. How some numbers written on a tablet in the year 2010 could come to represent this exact location must be some sort of crazy cosmic coincidence. Perhaps. Ops, is there anything of tangible value on this world? Scanners calibrating. Yes, there appears to be a nanoschematic for improving the efficiency of our network, Commander. This tech will allow the construction of nodes that will provide a global speed-up to all packets. This could be very useful for supporting larger networks and keeping blasters and mortars well-supported over long distances. Commander, remember that blasters cannot fire at elevations higher than themselves. Since you will have to fight up the steps of the Great Pyramid, you will have to be aggressive with your blasters and move them into the Creeper. The blasters can take some moderate exposure to the Creeper, just make sure you have the blasters supplied with a nearby network node when you make a move to higher ground. Wow. You people have put me in a very bad location. And again, gonna try not to be quite as OCD about it. I can tend to be overly analytical about making the positioning of my stuff way too perfect. And that can be a bad thing in situations like this. So, if I do that, trying to get the energy production to outrank the amount of energy being used. I'm waiting to see how much of an impact that makes. There we go. So, also going to start putting some collectors up here for all the good they'll do. Ah, typical. I would have had to have put one there anyway. Okay, so. Getting this pass protected is my current objective because I find that that appears to be an efficient way of dealing with the Creeper from getting over the wall is just more or less making the wall into a barricade. I mean, a protective barricade. And of course, I'm putting too much energy into the network now. I didn't expect those collectors to begin producing already. I mean, to begin building already. If they were producing already, it wouldn't be a problem. If they start producing energy early, then fine by me. Packet speed tech now available. Seems like a useful tech, but it does not increase the rate at which packets are released into the network. It just increases the speed at which they travel across the network. There's times where it's useful. Not saying it's not useful. It's just at this early point in the game, protection. I mean, getting things built up takes precedence, because that stuff's eating through the walls already. Okay, then. There we go. Now it's pulling back. And with it pulling back, I can use these lower steps and terrain as more energy production land. Collects fractal space energy from its surroundings. Collectors are the backbone of any successful network. So apparently they absorb just some form of sci-fi ambient energy stuff that's not really explained beyond fractal. But I have no complaints there. It's very well designed and well described. Yeah, I'm using up more energy than I'm producing, and that's gonna let the creeper start seeping back through the wall. I'm using 3, and I'm collecting 3.1. Now I'm using 3.5 because something else has begun building. I'm building too much at once is the issue there. Okay, a couple more just came online. See, that's about to eat through the walls and just overrun the city itself. Come on. Come on, you can do it. Oh, I'm gonna lose this level, aren't I? Nope, maybe, maybe. Pull it back, pull it back, pull it back. This part of the wall right here is really worrying me. Yep. Oh, good. The guns pulled it back right when it ate through the wall. Ah, it's cutting it a bit close. But hey, I'll take it. I'm just gonna go ahead and put those two there so that that wall is no longer at a risk. It'll have to go over the wall. Which it can't currently do, as long as I keep an eye on it. So we've got pretty good coverage of the area. I mean, I'm not gonna build collectors to grab some of these tinier spots. I'm gonna go ahead and melt some relays there. Well, that didn't help me at all, like I was hoping it would. I shouldn't have built four of those all at once. Rebuilding that is actually pointless. Well, I just threw away a bunch of energy. That was nearly finished. I am not making good decisions here, am I? Okay. Okay, so that's 3 out of 4 energy producers. I mean, energy savers. Money saver. It reminds me of a newspaper. Penny saver, sorry. Yeah, the guns aren't gonna help forever. But I need some way to produce more energy because I'm currently sucking it up faster than I can use it. I mean, faster than I can produce it. Let's do that. Because if I can completely, like, shut down that flow. There we go. Well, that's really lowered the energy consumption for the network. It's because it relies on this one node that worries me. Come on, you've almost got him finished. There you go. Let's hope that works. I've almost completely shut that one down by accident. There we go. There we go. See, that one's not going to play as nice. There we go, that'll work. Just throw that over there and be done with it. Roar! And yeah, you see the levels are getting a bit longer. Or more time consuming, I mean. I do really enjoy this fusion of real-time strategy and tower defense. Well, I've shut that one down. I'm gonna go ahead and shut this one down too. Well, I've shut down the creeper for this level. This is the point where you wonder, couldn't we just live here forever, but then more creeper spores might appear? That's not a good long-term strategy. Unless you like living with the threat of imminent collapse constantly. And that was Planet Ara. Next, Corvus. Oh goodness, this one's a little bit of a pain. The once lush ocean world of Corvus. I always dreamed of visiting this beautiful world. Now it is a dry, barren rock. The creeper knows no end to its destructive power. Commander, I must show you. I show something on scanners. My gods, there are survivor pods on this world. They must have recently landed after staying in orbit as long as possible. Notify the medical centers to expect casualties. We're going to save those people. Too many have been taken by the creeper already. The whole city is on alert status and medical are mobilizing. Build out a network to connect to the pods and we can rescue the survivors. Sensors show that the creeper has massed and is rushing this way in a wave like we have never encountered. It must have sensed the survivors somehow. You need to act quickly and aggressively to save the survivors. Go get them, Commander! Okay. I think the first thing I usually do is that. Figure out the most effective way to connect the network, and then more or less begin sending out relays. Okay. See, this last one's gonna be... I think I'll actually have to use that method. Because I'm just not going to have the energy to be able to send out more direct ground level relays. There we go. That's two less relays, and just as effective of a ground coverage. I could probably reduce it by one more, but since that's already in construction, survivors rescued. Survivors rescued some more. Survivors rescued even more. This one's always slightly stressful. Because, if you don't rush to get them, the creeper can and will overtake enough to make that difficult. And I don't like leaving anyone behind. Ah! Yeah, see, I'm having to pull the network onto higher ground now. Okay, now it sends out to those two. I'm pushing it a little bit by trying to add some energy collectors along the way to increase the speed at which it can send out packets, because otherwise it's going to send out packets faster than it can produce energy. Okay, one more for there. Then it's just got to connect to that. And that's the main. That one's never going to survive, is it? Oh. Are you kidding me? It had one packet left and it was almost there. Oh, victim of bad timing. Survivors rescued. These islands also make very effective areas for doing that. Yeah, this one's worrying me because that creeper is going to get there real soon. I can always throw a blaster up there. Okay, so now that's going there, that's going there. That one's saved, that one will be saved, that one worries me. Not trying to be overly quiet here, I'm like slightly struck. Ah! Wait, no, that can stay disconnected for now. That doesn't have to be connected at this moment, and that escape pod is worrying me badly. Almost. Why are you not sending resources this way? Okay, there you go. And that's where the speed boosters are useful. And that's where I'm sending out more energy than I can produce. Like, I literally don't like finishing the level without saving the escape pods. Oh, I don't see that escape pod surviving. Oh no. There we go. Oh, so it literally won't let you if you don't save them all. But we're at the 20-minute mark, so we will save them all next time. Hopefully. So, see you next time.